Hi! In this video, we're going to take a quick look at one of the Cinema 4D features that is probably a little bit more unknown to a lot of folks, but it's really useful. It's the regular grid option. So if you know what this option is, then you already know where I'm going, but if not, stay tuned to find out what it does and why it might be important to you. So as we start off, we have a simple scene here. We have an extrude nerves object and a spline. The spline is a fairly organic shape, and if I go to the 4-pane view, you can see that the spline controls the extrusion just like you're used to. What if we wanted to bend this extrusion or deform it in any other way? Well, simple. We would just take a deformer like this bend deformer that I've got set up, and then we would simply increase the strength of the bend to bend it. But we can immediately see a problem. As we bend our object, the caps and the hull of the object bends quite well, but the caps and the rounding doesn't bend so nicely. Why is this? Well, if we look at the wireframe, we can see that the cap of this object is just one giant N-gon. So how do we fix this? Well, in Cinema 4D, there's a lot of defaults happening. For splines, for instance, they default to adaptive points with an angle of 5 degrees. So 5 degrees of change on the tangents of this edge is going to create new edges. So if it changes this to 10 degrees, it needs to bend a little bit more before it decides, hey, I'm going to put an extra edge in. So let's leave that at 10 degrees for now. Now what about the surface of this object? Well, if we go to the extrude nerve setting, we can see that currently the type is N-gons. What if we change the type to triangles? Well, it looks like the same things, because N-gons need to be triangulated at some point, and Cinema 4D is using the same math to do both of them. If we change it to quadrangles, however, we get a little bit better of a result, but the problem is still there. If we turn on the regular grid option, the problem goes away. So by adding a regular grid of polygons to this object, we can actually fix the issue. But we can get a little bit more stylish with this. Currently, we're using the adaptive algorithm to do the subdivision of the spline. If we were to change this to the subdivided algorithm, we get another control. We have angle and maximum length. So maximum length in this case is the longest that an edge is allowed to be. Now, these two options seem kind of superfluous considering that you can do natural, uniform, or adaptive. Now subdivided. Well, it turns out that this maximum length parameter almost directly correlates with the regular grid. So if I make my regular grid 10 inches, it sort of matches up with my spline's maximum length. So here we can see, if I turn off lines, you can see that you get a perfectly smooth curve now on an extruded object. Now this tip goes really well with last time's tip of the connect object. So if we were to add a connect object to the mix, we see that we actually can combine both of those for a pretty good effect. Still get a little bit of artifacts around the edges, but that's to be expected. You can always increase your subdivision and put more segments in the grid if that's an issue for you. But I just thought it would be nice to share this tip. The regular grid option came in a few versions ago. And I believe the subdivided spline option came in around the same time. So just to reiterate what we talked about, if you look at 10 degrees, if we change that to 5 degrees, it still maintains that regular grid where it can. And for the extrude nerves, if our regular grid was 5 inches, it would be a much tighter grid. We can change our spline subdivision to 5 inches as well, and it does a pretty good job at matching the general tessellation of this object. So, I hope this was helpful, and I hope that you're able to use the regular grid option and the subdivided spline option in the future. So, until next time, see ya!